Hey there, welcome to the Ozone Active channel, and today we have a special feature with my man Justice over here, who is a parkour athlete, or free running. You also call it free running, right?
Yeah, free running, parkour, free
Same
running
thing. Parkour. He Same does thing. It all. Today's episode we're gonna have it with Justice. Hey, welcome, man.
Thank you for having me here. You know, I watched episode one, episode two.
For real?
Oh, man, it was dope. Found it dope. I was like, yo. Yeah. But I never thought I would find myself here. And it's really an honor being here, man.
Thank you for being here. I'd really love you to be on this show. So, what I want to start off with is, why parkour? Can you explain that to me?
When I think about it now, I feel like everyone actually has done it. They actually used to do parkour free running when you're a kid, you know, when you play outside and you used to jump over a hall. Or even in your kitchen when you're walking, you find your tiles. You know that thing where you get, you just do that, you know? But you're actually doing that unconsciously without actually knowing that you're doing it. Yeah, so that feeling of fight or flight situation where you feel that adrenaline of that situation, that feeling. That whole feeling is the reason why I felt like, what if I can actually do this consciously and being able to control that feeling. So, that feeling is not, it's too much.
That is interesting. So, I'm sure most people don't even know what parkour is. They don't know what the sport of parkour is. Can you please explain what it is?
Parkour basically is, it's actually not a sport.
It's not a sport?
Well, most people see it as a sport. Yeah, it can, just by talk, it can fall under the bracket of sport, but it's actually not a sport, it's an art.
Oh.
The same way we've got martial arts, we can subconsciously just speak about it and say, yeah, you know that sport, martial arts.
Yeah, definitely.
You see, yeah. So, it's an art. What makes it stand out is that you are trying to move your body, or you're trying to move from point A to point B using your body in the most efficient way you can. So that's what actually parkour or free running is. It's just you trying to move from one point to another with your body, maybe the fastest way, most efficient way.
Yes.
You know, the certain factors you can actually use in measuring your parkour.
So, I'd like to know that, how do you actually feel when you're doing parkour? Is it like, I can't even imagine the feeling that you would get in doing parkour, man.
No, now that I think about it, it's actually a good feeling. It's a positive feeling.
Yeah.
A good scenario I can use is when maybe you're being chased by a dog.
Yeah.
You actually go over a wall that you never thought you'd go over.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Right after you're on the other side of the wall, you actually look at the scenario, what just happened now. You're like, you feel good, man. You feel like John Wick. You feel like, I did something.
Yeah.
But imagine having that feeling constantly,
yes,
more than once, more than twice, in parkour relation, is whereby you're trying to go over or you're trying to accomplish a certain thing, whereby you get your scenario, you see point A to point B, and you try, you fail, you try, you fail. And when you eventually accomplish it, can you imagine that feeling? Ask you as well, man. With any trials that we actually face, once you actually accomplish them, it's a very good feeling.
It is a very good feeling, I understand. Is there any way that you can actually use parkour in your life? You know, can it be directly applied to your life?
Definitely. It does a lot. For example, the mindset that you actually get to develop in doing parkour. You get to have a mindset of accomplishing things. And I find myself having the same mindset when I'm studying.
Yeah.
When I'm working, you know, I get to accomplish those things by using the same mindset with a positive mood into it, with the most efficient way I can, you know. So, you know, daily life, man, it's good. It can also be used as self-defense.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. So, the good thing about the whole sport is that it also gets to sharpen your mind, you know. It enhances your instincts, you know. So, when you find yourself in a situation where you can, you're not in charge of it, you can actually get to be in control of it. You can actually get to see. Instead of saying, I did not see what happened, you can instead say, I actually saw what happened.
Okay. Last question. Dangers. The dangers of doing parkour. Hey man, I could imagine doing parkour and jumping over buildings. Those things seem terrifying. So, are the dangers as big as we think they are?
No, one thing that people usually describe us as.
Yeah.
Can be like, I do parkour. They'll be like, what? And like, yeah, I do parkour. I don't know. I don't know what's that. Then you'll be like, it's actually jumping buildings.
Yeah.
They'll be like, oh,
that one.
You know. So yeah, man. There is actually there is dangers.
Yes.
Just like any other sport. You know?
Okay.
You look at rugby. You look at soccer. Anything. There is dangers into it, but there's actually safety precautions that you have to actually follow when it comes to doing it. For example, in rugby, you're not allowed to tackle someone from behind.
Yes.
You know, that's actually a call. You get a red card for that.
Yeah,
same applies in parkour. One of the first things that we actually teach you before you the actual jumping, you actually don't really jump over it, but before you actually start doing the actual thing, one of the first things we teach you is safety of things. There's the safety roll, there's safety moves, so that instead of just knowing how to do it when you're doing parkour, but in your daily lives, in your normal daily lives. You know, there's a say that says you learn to walk before you can run.
Yes.
You learn to crawl before you can actually walk.
Yes.
So there's actually baby steps in this. No, you don't just get, you don't just start by just jumping 5 feet, you know.
Okay.
Instead, you try one, you know, once you accomplish the one, you test your limit.
Yes.
Two, now I'm gonna do 1.5.
Yes.
Once you accomplish the 1.5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, is it gone? And that's how you actually get to improve. That's how you actually get to become better at the skill.
That's how you minimize the risk.
And I feel like you can actually apply that in anything else in life, you know. You take baby steps into it until you actually become in control of the situation.
Now that makes sense. Hey, amen. So I hear that you have a couple of things that you want to show us.
So I'll show you two moves, right? I'll show you the safety rope.
Yes.
And then I'll show you the Kong.
Okay, cool.
Kong is one of the most, you don't have to do parkour. It's one of the coolest things that you can actually want to even start doing today.
I know that throughout this video, talking like I actually can't do parkour at all, but I can do a few stuff. So I think I'll also maybe show the viewers how to do a side flip and that'll work out.
No problem. Cool. I know you cut the side flip so good.
Thanks, man.
So now I'll be showing you the Kong. So let's go into it. The awesome thing about Kong is that you can either do it just to go over an obstacle, like a chair or a bench, or you can either do it just to move from point A to point B, or as a combination move, which is my favorite, like a Kong to side flip. And these are the progression moves to a Kong. So the first step to getting the Kong is getting the monkey. As you run towards your obstacle with your hands slightly forward, the next important thing is to jump. And instead of your hands stopping your whole momentum, this time they help you increase your whole movement and push. And this is the safety roll. You can either do it just after you've done a flip, or you can actually do it if you jump in from a high place. This is to prevent you from hitting your ankles or anything. And this is the steps to doing the roll. So the first thing is you open a pocket for yourself. So it creates a whole momentum, which even allows you to roll forward and backwards. It's almost as if you've done just a replay, you know, of the whole thing. There's a part of your body which is called your scapula, which is actually your shoulder, right? So show you from a different angle. It helps you roll, right? That's what you use to roll, not your head. Your head doesn't get to touch the ground. So what I can do is just open it for myself, and then you can actually check my head is actually clean. There's no grass, right? You can roll with it. You can do it backwards. So, yeah.
a side flip, a really cool looking flip, man. Just go sideways, the sideways over front flip. So what you have to do if you want to go through the side flip, there's just three requirements that you have to do in practicing it: run and practice that jump, and after that you can then practice a rolling on the floor. Then the third one is to just get a buddy and to roll on his back. Once you get that motion down, it'll be easy enough for you to run, you jump, this is the second part, you have your stomp to it. Then after you have your stomp, you lift off in the air, and after you lift off, you try to tuck. After you've tucked, you will then land, and that's a side flip.
Come on. So we're going for the challenge. It's challenge time. Hope you guys are ready. So in this challenge time, we're gonna be doing a parkour course. Basically, what we're gonna be doing is that the course starts here. You run up, place over here. Okay. You wanna go up, you know, and go through that. Over here to over this thing, and whoever reaches up there at the shortest time wins. Me versus Justice. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready, definitely.
Cool stuff. Let's get running.
So what you guys have to do is that guess who won, and then at the end we'll reveal, at the end of the show we'll reveal who won. So who do you think won, Justice?
I feel like I liked it, but I feel like he won, but I don't know, I also trust myself at the same time.
Yeah?
So yeah.
I will just have to see, just have to see. I definitely think I won. So that's the end of the episode. Man, Justice, thank you for being here.
Man, it's a pleasure being here, man.
Yeah?
It's been a while since I've done it, but I like the fact that you push ourselves.
Yes.
Now we actually accomplished a few things, so I'm happy being here, and thank you for having me here, man.
And thank you for being here. Shows that you can be active in your own way. It doesn't have to be, you know, calisthenics or anything that I'm pushing. The same thing that you're doing, if it's parkour, if it's boxing, if it's swimming, go for it. Just be active in your way. Also active, stay active.
Show to you on this special episode was proudly brought to you by Freaksins. If you feel like it was sick and would like to cop your own, purchase a hoodie, shirt, sweatpants or socks on their online store. Google search Freaksins and alternatively check them out on Insta. Watch out for the Free Thinker collection. Cop Southside merch.